is Amb Utchay do? Let me tell you how you are.
Very special.
Because Amb Utchay is spelled U-T-C-H-A-Y. This is why I call him Ucha now. But he says it's Uche. Not U-C-H-E.
No, U-T-C-H-A-Y.
That's your own.
Yeah, that's my own.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
And I'm in Nigeria. So.
We're talking of having to douse. First of all, we need to douse the mood of the people.
Yeah, yeah.
At least to create an avenue for the forker to hear the forkerer. That's necessary. Because at the end of the day, there's the you can't rule out that option of dialogue.
Mm-hmm.
We need to sit down and find solutions to the problem. Even the judicial commissioners of inquiry that are sitting across the federation, it's a kind of dialogue. People have to come and spill out their mind, and then government would then have to listen to them and then do the needful. So, dialogue is still an option. But then we need to douse the current mood. We can't be dialoguing when some people will, in the dead of the night, organize themselves and go and attack
either
fellow human beings or attack a particular office because they think palliatives are kept there. Yeah. And it's gone beyond people searching for palliatives. Because I cannot understand for the life of me why people will loot, as I was reading in the papers just before coming here, 110 tractors looted from a private company. Tractors, we are not talking of something you take and put in your pocket. The one who that is popular on Facebook, you saw more than that, having to push one tractor away.
Amazing.
I wonder for how long has this been going on in their mind that if we have the opportunity, this is what we are going to do to you. So we need to end all of that first. How do we do so? How do we bring it to an end? Justice for all. Yeah.
Okay, first of all, I want to say this, that somebody that is in leadership or a leader that has no follower is not a leader. He's just taking a walk. That's it. If you're a leader and you don't have followers and there's no connect, you're just taking a walk. Just like strolling from AIT station for a year to Wuse alone. And sorry to say this, is exactly the narrative of the Nigerian leadership. What I'm talking about, I'm talking about from the top to down. The people are not carried along. The Nigerian citizens are far away from their leaders.
Disconnected entirely.
I just remember that was a few weeks ago. I was actually speaking in a conference and I said something. I said, why is it that somebody will be given a portfolio as a local government chairman just few months, like a month after then, he has a convoy? Normally he was working, but now he has like how many policemen? Who is pursuing you to kill? Whose money did you steal? You see that kind of culture. I'm sorry, there's no sorry about this, but that slave trade mentality is still working in our system in Nigeria. That thing of genuine leadership, that thing of service. What is leadership? Leadership is service, serving the people. Like somebody said online, he said, the people that we elected, they are actually elected to serve us. It means that the president is serving me, the governor is serving me, commissioner is serving me, and us. But in Nigeria, far away, that's what we're having the problem we're having right now. And amazingly, I'm connected to the youth and everything. I mean, the things that we do are all about the youth all around in African countries and the rest of it. And also the project we do for the National Youth Summit in Nigeria. I talk to these young people normally. Now, guess what? It's amazing that the young people don't even see themselves as part of the system. If you talk to some young people, they see themselves as foreigners. Nigeria, when you tell them to say things like God bless Nigeria, they don't even want to say it, but they are like, it looks as if they came visiting in Nigeria. I mean, that consciousness is not there. Why? Because of the way the leaders, I mean, everything is just, we need to, first of all, correct our leadership system. First of all, our leaders need to understand that you are called to serve, you are elected to serve. And one of the things that we're going to achieve in this country that I'll be so proud of, which I trust God that in a short while we're going to achieve, let's make government offices less attractive.
In that case,
yes,
it will be easier for people to resign.
That is it.
Cornelius
was saying, looking at Belema, we're just laughing. Somebody resigned in Nigeria, a governor
resigned from all the
felt like how much to get into seat, which is ridiculous. It should make it less attractive because it looks like a do or die affair. It should get to the level that somebody, they make somebody a governor 3 or 4 or 5 months after, the person be like, sorry, I can't continue. I thought it was business as usual, but I'm done. We need to get to that level if we want to grow. Our leaders are our servant. Governor, you are our servant. That's what it is. That's what it is. I mean,
let this whole thing stop. Servant leader.
Exactly, servant leader. So let this whole thing stop. You have little power. You want to kill everybody. You want to oppress everybody out. A governor grows with almost 20 vehicles, all brand new jeeps, on taxpayers' money. Come on now. Come on. That's not fair. And the citizens are watching. So, Benga, answer this question. Is it possible that if there's an opportunity, they are not going to go? Many of them say, in fact, some of them came out of television and were giving testimony when they collected the palliative. They were like, I thank God, though, for this breakthrough. Imagine thanking God for the bad thing that you have done. So, it goes to show you the way our people think. And it's costly of leadership. Everything rises and falls on leadership.
So,